And so try to be open, aware, and allowing as the communication within your vision occurs. What are you receiving back now that you have expressed? If you ask a question, you will receive an answer. If you make a statement, the vision will change in some way. You may continue to communicate in this way, offering your dialogue and receiving theirs back. Do this for a few moments, just out of curiosity, to understand how this communication occurs. Good. Now we will ask you to bring your awareness back to the present moment, staying as this field of open spiritual consciousness. Stop the dialoguing and just return to a state of awareness. Feel now the area of your spiritual heart, and just be present to that which is within you. In this first exercise, we establish telepathic communication with a non-physical being. The being you have imagined may likely exist within a natural dimension state, and so in the astral plane communications with beings not incarnate within this world, we often interact in higher dimensions, greater non-physical dimensions. Many beings within this world exist in dimensions above the physical, in states of higher frequencies. Often our spiritual teachers, often our gurus who are disincarnate, often ascended masters or spiritual guides will communicate from these higher states. And within our fields of perception, it often occurs within the area in front of our foreheads. Now we will open up your perception to another region of communication existing within your human experience. This region is located above the ears. It is a region of your brain that has a communication network in the non-physical area built in with the beings operating within this planetary system. And so if we are to communicate with physical beings within this world in a telepathic way, it can happen either through the third eye center, beaming out to the forehead, or also out to the sides of the ears. Often when we hear things happening spontaneously around us, such as sounds within the mental dimension, it happens above the ears. But when another being wishes to communicate directly to us, then it happens to the area in the forehead. This is important to understand. The forehead region will often communicate in the non-physical astral plane with higher dimensional beings, and will often receive the direct communication, the telepathic communication sent from human beings who have a higher spiritual consciousness. The region above the ears on the sides of the head often relates to human beings with lower spiritual consciousnesses, and for non-physical astral beings bound upon this physical earth, meaning that they are in an energetic dimension related to the same dimension of this physical planet. We are simply giving you a map to help yourself understand your communication better. It is in no way a judgment against the different beings and where they shall communicate. And so, close your eyes, feel your heart, connect more fully with the higher self-consciousness that you are, letting it rise up to the area of your brain. And now listen. Listen with your ears. Try to feel the energetic field of yourself above and around your physical ears. And then try to listen as if you are tuning into sounds beyond this physical dimension. As you listen, you are opening your perception in this aspect of your human experience. What is often also needed is a choice of that which you wish to listen to. Remember, it is your intention that directs your experience, and so often we need to intend to listen to something in order to begin to perceive it. During times in our daily lives, we may simply hear thoughts of other people in this region of our brain and mental center. We may receive distracting sounds or noises just as we continue to live our lives. And so often this area will receive automatically. But in order to fine-tune it, we can also focus our attention there and direct this part of our experience.